Hey, how's it going, everybody? I was just going through some archival footage of a show that Rick and I used to do called Rolling Art. And we did do a couple of lowrider segments. I want you to check out this segment we did with Peter Toma, a great friend of ours, and he is one of the best in the Radical Custom class. Check it. Guys, we're here with Peter Toma, and this is something to be seen. Tell us about it, Peter.
Well, it's a 1950 Plymouth Deluxe. Me and my brother, you know, modified the car. You know, we have 7 years with the car. We just one day said, we're gonna start customizing our own car and show people that a Plymouth can get to the top, you know? We did some modifications. Every single year, we changed it, you know, before the Super Show. We changed it from root beer brown to root beer.
Wait a minute, every year you change the color of the car?
Color of the car, the upholstery. We changed the upholstery, the engines, the suspension. New mods, every year new mods, except the front clip, you know, we added on to it. If we had some mods already, we added on to it.
That's like over the top, man.
Yeah, over the top. So we just keep doing that every year. Now I have the new look from the Super Show. I'm a retired bomb of the year worldwide, you know. It's going Germany for 5 months. Really big thing going on over there. I never been there. This is the first time it's going there. I have the new modifications on it, like you can see behind me. You know, I have the 68 Corvette engine with the tune port, and I did my own little customizing on the engine, made custom brackets, cut the heads, you know, shaped them up, and then I put two superchargers, 235 horsepower each one.
You know. How often do you actually drive it? I know it's pretty much a show car, but how much
it's
do you
It's a show car right now, you know, but eventually, because it's retired, we're gonna put it on the road. You know, the only thing that's left to do that to make it go on the road constantly is just add a fan to it and that's it. You know, but for right now, we drive it off the trailer. We go to picnics with it once in a while that are close by our house, you know, things like that. We drive it, you know. It's an operatable car. We don't push our cars. Us in LA over here, that we build our cars in LA, our main rule is car has to be operatable for street. Right. That means registered, you know, get in it. If it's right-hand drive, operatable. Get on the street, drive it. If you want to floor it, floor it. It has to handle it. If it doesn't handle it, then you didn't build your car right.
There you go.
You know, so that's our main goal. We made an operatable car street to be radical, which, you know, the car is...
Certainly is radical for sure.
Yeah, you can see I cut it up in all kinds of pieces. It closes up, locks up. I can get in and drive.
Is that what you're going to be judged in, radical?
Yeah, I am going to be judged in radical today. You know.
Best of luck.
Yeah, thank you very much.
One last question. What does low riding mean to you?
Well, low riding, a lot of people put it like a hobby and everything, but for me and my brothers, our life. Low riding is our life. We like to build cars. We like to see cars that were ugly look into beautiful cars, to look like a model car, you know, but actually have your fun out of it. You know, low riding to us, you know, is like a lot of people, you know, say, oh, they put us some rims on it and everything and say, hey, I'm a low rider. To us, went beyond that.
Absolutely.
You know, we took it to another beyond. We looked that up at Elite Car Club, you know, and all these car clubs from back in the days, you know, and they inspired us. We were kids and we looked at them and said, one of these days, I'm gonna build a car like them, you know? So we just looked up to them and we just got into it and did it.
Well, thank goodness that they are positive role models for you guys.
Yeah.
And best of luck to you.
Okay, thank you very much.
There you go, your national champion, Bronco Bill.